parkway late last night. And as I sat with the echoes of the lies that I told, I felt young, never changed, but crooked heart. So put the shotgun back in the glove. Come on, wait another year for the sheep forward to come home, to be brave. Well, everything has changed, and now it's only you that matters. I will find any way to your wild heart.
Good afternoon. Today is Friday, January 18th.
Now over to Jamie with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "The time is always right to do what is right," by Martin Luther King Jr. Lunch for today is buckskin bowl and no hot combo. And lunch for Monday is French bread pizza and a hot combo of cheeseburger. Now, over to your weather report.
Hey, what's up, you guys?
Today, guys.
Oh.
Hey, what's up, you guys?
Okay, so the weather for today is going to be cloudy.
It's going to be a high of 40 and a low of 27.
And the weather for tomorrow is going to be very snowy, so that's fun.
Yeah, and it's going to be a high of 35 with a low of 32.
Okay, now for headline news. But no, I'm sorry.
Sophia.
Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta getting ready to host Super Bowl 53.
We're concerned. It's frustrating. It's concerning.
City officials are worried the shutdown will produce chaos for fans flying in to see the game.
There are real concerns about will our airport be up and functioning in the way that we need it to be.
Nearly 4,500 miles away from Atlanta, different kinds of concerns in Honolulu. Hawaiian officials say some federal disaster relief and economic aid for last year's volcano eruptions is tied up due to the shutdown.
While the lava has taken a time out, the devastation on the Big Island is left there for the residents to deal with.
Even farther away, the shutdown's effect is felt in Davos, Switzerland. The annual World Economic Forum will not have a delegation from the White House. White House spokeswoman Sarah Sanders said the trip was canceled out of consideration for the 800,000 great American workers not receiving pay. Meanwhile, neither side seems ready to bend at this stalemate.
While many Democrats in the House and Senate would like to make a deal, Speaker Pelosi will not let them negotiate.
What negotiating table are we not at? The last one we went to, I think, was a setup.
I'm John Lawrence reporting.
Attention all students that are either turning 16 in the next few months or older. All driver's education courses are currently having open enrollment from now, Thursday, January 31st. Please see Ms. Young in the attendance office for information on enrolling. The next enrollment period will be the first 3 weeks of May. Greystone Manor Therapeutic Riding Center is offering a new volunteer orientation on Saturday, January 26th from 10 a.m. till 12 p.m. Go to www.greatestermanatrc.org to learn more. Now over to Film Paul.
Young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and bold. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder.
It's Karis.
And Becca.
And this is Film Talk.
Karis, have you seen the new Spider-Man trailer yet?
I haven't gotten to it yet.
You haven't seen it? It's literally the best thing ever, and you haven't seen it?
Why do they keep making Spider movies anyway?
Because they're good.
You know what else is good? Our first movie, Stan and Ollie.
This film follows the true story of Laurel and Hardy, two comedians who travel the world bringing joy to all of their viewers.
The best friends are tested as they embark on their entertainment journey.
This comedy is sure to bring a tear to your eye.
Tears of joy or sadness?
Yes.
Our next film is If Beale Street Could Talk.
In the early 1970s Harlem, daughter and wife-to-be Tish Rivers, played by Kiki Layne, has a strong connection to her fiancé.
Fonny, played by Stephen James, is convicted of a crime he did not commit.
The couple struggles with trying to prove him innocent while their wedding plans are being pushed off.
A pregnancy and the love between them keep them fighting for their love.
This movie will keep you on the edge of your seat and probably break your heart.
Our feature movie for this week is Glass.
M. Night Shyamalan, the director of films like Unbreakable, Touchstone, and 2016 Split, introduces an all-new comic book thriller, Glass.
From Unbreakable, Bruce Willis returns as David Dunn, as does Samuel L. Jackson as Elijah Price, known by his pseudonym, Mr. Glass.
Joining from Split are James McAvoy reprising his role as Kevin Wendell Crumb and the multiple identities who reside within, and Anya Taylor-Joy as Casey Cook, the only captive to survive an encounter with the Beast.
Following the conclusion of the split, Glass finds Dunn pursuing Crumb's superhuman figure as the Beast in a series of unfortunate events, while the shadowy presence of Price emerges as a leader who holds critical secrets to both men.
Joining the cast are Unbreakable Spencer Tree Clark and Charlaine Woodard, who reprise their roles as Dunn's son and Price's mother, as well as Golden Globe winner Sarah Paulson from the American Horror Story series.
All right, Becca, I think that's enough information.
Now, over to the trailer.
It's amazing to meet you. It is simply extraordinary. Maybe this will all make sense if I explain who I am.
My name is Dr. Ellie Staple, and I'm a psychiatrist.
My work concerns a particular type of delusion of grandeur. It's a growing field. I specialize in those individuals who believe they are superheroes.
Good for you.
The three of you've convinced yourselves you have extraordinary gifts like something out of a comic book. David Dunn, the only person to survive that train wreck all those years ago.
What do you do?
I'm in security.
You think you have superpowers?
It's a feeling. Vision. I have to touch them.
You believe you are a protector.
My name is Patricia.
I have no question. There are 2 dozen identities.
I'm Mary Reynolds.
Por favor, senora.
We almost got you, bro.
That live in that body with you.
The Beast is coming any minute now for you guys.
But what I am questioning is your belief that you are something more than human.
And yet, it is true.
My bones break easily. I've had 94 breaks in my life.
But you have an extraordinary IQ.
This is not a cartoon. This is the real world.
No way.
And yet, some of us still don't die with bullets. Some of us can still bend steel. I have been waiting for the world to see that we exist. May I meet the Beast?
I hope for your sake that he likes you.
That sounds like the bad guys teaming up. A lot of people are going to die.
Don't do this.
Are you ready?
What do we call you, sir?
First name, Mister. Last name, Glass.
Are you a singer, dancer, musician, or comedian? Do you have a hidden talent or act that needs to be shared with the world? Audition for CV's Got Talent. Student Council is looking for talented people to perform at the talent show on March 3rd. To sign up for auditions, go to tinyurl.com/cvtalent and fill out the form. Auditions will be held after school on February 4th through 6th. You must sign up to audition by January 25th. Visit the bulletin board outside the cafeteria or Student Council's social media accounts for more information. On Wednesday, February 6th at 3:30 p.m., the Conestoga Valley Athletic Department will be recognizing seniors from the class of 2019 who have been offered athletic scholarships from a Division I or II institution or who have committed to a Division III institution to continue their athletic careers. Students must represent or must have represented Conestoga Valley on a sports team for at least their senior year. Any senior who plans to continue their athletic career in college, please contact Dinah Henry, Athletic Director, no later than Friday, January 18th, to receive more information on required items to submit to participate in the ceremony. All items must have been submitted by January 25th. Now over to CV Sports.
There's an away boys basketball game at Lebanon at 7:30.
There's a home girls basketball game against Lebanon at 7:30.
There's a home bowling match against Lebanon at 3:30, dismissal at 2:15.
Come out and support the Bucks.
Now over to sports highlights.
Lineups first of all for the 21-16 Lakers, 13-6 here at not play at all last year against OKC. For the Thunder, they're healthy. They're ready to go.
Shots, and they also like to use that leg to play off a guy like Russell Westbrook. So, you know, see that? Again, that's a lot to add.
Dallas, the Mavs had 29 turnovers. Grant blocked by McGee! Boy, Jeremy Grant is a high-fly act, but Westbrook has averaged the triple-double the last 2 years, averaging one again. The cut by Ferguson, and he throws it. Leads his team in scoring, free throws, and minutes played. Oh, Brandon Ingram! Beautiful! Goes the other way. And good ball, Bourbon. Stevenson behind his back. Had Schroeder in front. Here goes Lance. All the way. Dish it. Dunk. Great play. Grant, long shot, long rebound. Here come the Lakers. Stevenson gives it. Lonzo Hart got it! That's 8-0 Laker run. They lead by four. At the other end, that one, 3.5 to play. Here's Chandler out there. There's a speculation about his back. One official game from the Lakers. Here's Hart hit the
out, and they've got to get the ball out of Paul George's hands.
Paul George with the left-handed dribble, lob underneath. That's a good dish. Near best scoring average for him, too. He's in his ninth year. And now he just puts a little exclamation
there. There's the assist for Mr.
Westbrook. He's having trouble. He's amongst the league leaders in turnovers, too. He had a double-double tonight. But a tough fourth quarter. And he made it. And his first bucket was a 20. That time. That one was close. 3-for-20 for Westbrook. KCP. That's his fifth three.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I'm Nick.
Alongside Jamie.
And this is CV10.
Have a frosty Friday. Look what you made me do.